Ooh, okay, so I ran into this girl. Okay, so this woman was telling me about how she was, how she not from here. She's from a different side of town, but then she was invited to, she was invited to a family reunion. This woman, she was invited, but she don't know how to tell that person that she don't want to go back. You know, she don't want to cancel, she don't want to reject the invitation that was given to her because she don't want to go back to that town because she know what it's about. She was like, if I go back around the people, then I know, already know how it's going to be. You know, I'm going to be pulled back into the same, you know, I'm going to be pulled back into that bullshit to where I came a long way, and I am not trying to go back to where that is. And I was, and then, I mean, I don't want to go back to those problems, you know, that environment, because, you know, and I was like, wow, you know. So that's just kind of like, once you move away from a certain situation, that you know, you don't want to go back. That's why when I thought about her, I'm just like, oh, you know, I can't wait to, you know, I can't wait to be in that position to where I'm so far away that I have that choice to go back, you know. And that's when I was telling her, I'm just like, I was like, maybe it's a challenge for you. Maybe this is something you need to face. You know, maybe that's me looking at it from, I guess, a different angle. I'm like, maybe it's just testing you to where if you can survive that time, if you can go back without, you know, thinking about, you know, going back. If you can go back without basically relapsing on all of that baggage that you used to go through, you know, if you can go back without having any type of effect, you know, without them having that effect on you or that impact on you or that influence over you, if you can go back without having that type of influence over you, then maybe that's confirmation for you. You know, maybe that's confirmation for your situation. You know, that just gives you a good feeling. Like, okay, you know, I went back, but it doesn't have this influence over me. I went back, but I don't feel any differently. You know, I went back, but I ain't think about this, that, or the third. So therefore, I'm done with my healing. You know, I'm good. And I feel like that's how I seen the situation. I was like, maybe that's what it is, you know? But she didn't take it like that. She was like, no, I'm not going back. And I feel like that was, honestly, I feel like maybe that's basically just showing that you're weak. You know, you're too weak to go back. You're too weak to deal with that. You know, maybe it's because you haven't fully, you know, that's closure. That's your closure. That's the closure you need, you know. But you're resisting it because you already know if you already seen yourself fail before it even happened. So yeah, and then she was like, well, no, I'm too old. I've been through that. You know, I'm at where I'm at. I'm this age. I don't think she said her age, but she's older. She's an older woman. She was like, I'm tired. You know, I'm not about to go back to that. You know, I'm not about to put myself in that situation because, you know, I don't got time. I don't got time for that. So she basically already made up her mind. She wasn't going back. And she just felt like, you know, she needed some type of she just didn't want to be mentally bothered by them. An idea can go on for so long, or someone can plant that seed. That was a seed planted into that woman's mind. You know, they planted that seed, and it was on her to, you know, act on it. So that's the type of effect people do. They have over you, and they can, you know. And sometimes that's probably something that she has been holding on for a long time, because she was thanking me because she needed somebody to talk to. Who knows how long she's been holding on to that? Like, she didn't want to react because she needed some type of clarity. She needed to talk about the issue. You know, people plant these seeds in your mind, and now it's like eating at your mind, and you don't, you know, you can't really fight that feeling, get some type of clarity yourself. Sometimes you just need to talk about it and release that idea, and or release whatever that is. It can be a bad seed, you know, a bad seed, and it's basically decaying in your soil, or it's, you know, molding, or something is happening to that seed to where now you have to release that bad energy. A bad seed and bad energy. You know, you have to find some type of way to release that bad energy that's been, you know. That has that type of toll over your mind. Yeah. So, I don't know. I just thought about that because it's just like, I don't know. If you don't deal with something before you move on, you know, you'll be constantly reminded. So it's like it's like that woman, was that reminder. You know, we're having a family reunion here. And it just triggered you right there, like, oh, you know, I don't really want to go back there. I've dealt with so much back there. But it could be, like I said, you know, it's a right reminder, and it's putting you in a position to where, you know, you got to think about it. You know, even though you don't want to go, your mind has already been taken to that place. You know, your mind already went there. So it's like sometimes you're put in situations to where you got to go and take back your mind. You have to go and face this because it's already taking your mind. You have to go back and get back what belongs to you. They put you in this position to where you have no other choice but to go back, you know, because they've. Put you in this place. I feel backed up right now because I can't really speak on exactly what exactly I want to say because there's so much on my mind right now. But I'm gonna go ahead and do the verse of the day. Maybe that gave me some type of clarity from the situation. Okay, so there is a special rest still waiting for the people of God. And this is Hebrews 4:9. So we are going to go to Hebrews 4:9. So the rest that God promised. Therefore, while the promise of entering this rest remains, let us fear lest any of you be judged to have failed to reach it. For good news came to us just as to them, but the message which they came from the but the message from which they heard did not benefit them because it did not meet with faith in the hearers. For we who have believed enter the rest, as he has said. As I swore in my wrath, they shall never enter my rest. Although his words were finished from the foundation of the world, for he has somewhere spoken of the seventh day in this way, and God rested on the seventh day from all his works. And again in this place he said, they shall never enter my rest, since therefore it remains for some to enter it, and those who formerly received the good news failed to enter because of disobedience. Again, he sets a certain day today, saying through David so long afterward in the words already quoted, today when you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. For if Joshua had given them rest, God would not speak later of another day. So then there remains a Sabbath rest for the people of God, for whoever enters God's rest also ceases from the labors as God did from his. Let us therefore strive to enter the rest, that no one fall by the same sort of disobedience. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and spirit, of joints and marrow, and discerning the thoughts of and intentions of the heart. And before him no creature is hidden, but also are open and laid bare to the eyes of him with whom we have to do. So that was the rest of God, Hebrews 3:11, 4, verse 1 through 13. So yeah, it's a lot of people that try to enter rest with you. You know, they try to enter into your rest. They try to They try to enter into your rest. They try to enter into your promise. You know, and this is them acting on disobedience. They're being disobedient because they're trying to steal. They're trying to make their way and force their way into a situation that they're not supposed to be into. They're not supposed to be in, you know. And this is disobedience. So After all that, whatever they've done to make this happen, and guess what? It doesn't happen. They didn't hear the promise. They did all this, you know. They applied themselves. They, you know, forced themselves into a situation. They took this, they took that, you know, and they still didn't hear the call. They didn't hear, you know, their rest, the time of rest, because they're not meant to have rest. You know, they're not meant to enter into God's promise. But that's what they do. That's what demons do. You know, that demonic energy, they just keep picking and picking and picking and trying to do everything they need to do to control a situation. They try to do anything they need to do, you know. To step into a situation that's not their own. To put themselves into a position that's not for them. To manipulate, to aggravate, to irritate, to bother. That's what they do. They just pick and they pick and they pick. Because guess what? It doesn't matter, you know? Guess what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You know, they've already fallen. They've already fallen. They're here, you know, just to pick at you. Any life that's here, that's still flourishing, they're here to cripple and disable, you know. They're demons for a reason. Just because we in the same body don't mean we have the same life or we contain the same goodness. Just because we're in it, we look the same, don't mean we are the same. You know? I can be a life. I'm full of life. I'm full of me. And you can be a demon and a vessel pretending to be me. Trying to control the situation. You know, they're trying to take you away from God's arm and put you down in a dark place to where, oh, God doesn't see you the same. So now it's my chance. Now it's my turn. I'm gonna hop up and I'm gonna do what I gotta do. You know, now it's my turn. They're trying to take your turn. They're trying to steal your time with God to play your role and be in your position so that they can, you know, seem like, you know, I'm this and I'm that and I'm the third. They're just trying to imitate, manipulate the situation, you know, take from you because God has favor on your life. And that's what it all comes down to, you know. And it sucks. And it sucks, but that's the truth. It's this world is this world is you know, that's what it is. The people is and it's not going to change because, you know, the world is the people. The people is the world. The only way it's going to be changed is if the people of this world was no more. That's the only way it's gonna change because they're like mold. It's like, you know, you see a tree and you see that tree, that the mold around the tree. That's how people are on this earth. It's like mold around the earth. They've been here too long. They've been feeling this way for too long, you know, and all they can do is project it onto the next person. Just like weeds, you know, you have a garden of weeds, you have all these flowers, you see these flowers, and then boom, you know, it's touched by the weeds and it starts to die. You know, just like mold spreads. So any life that's flourishing coming out of the ground, that mold is going to spread onto that, and eventually that flower is, you know, it dies. It goes back, you know, it dies. It loses its life. It loses its color, you know, because it's been touched by that mold. That's what people are. People are that mold, trying to touch you and infect you and take away any type of color or smell or aroma, you know, just like a flower. Flower smells good. It smells like life. It smells, you know, that's what these people are trying to do. They're trying to touch you. They're trying to touch you and just kill you off. It's not really about stealing, it's just about killing you off. You know, taking that life away from you, stopping the progress, you know, stopping your growth. That's what they want to do. They want to stop your growth. Because they're mold. They've been here too long. They're mold. Mold. You know? Ever seen a movie where you got all of these hands sticking out of a graveyard? You know, they're all of these, you know, demons trying to pull the human down. It's like an image. I can look up that image and show exactly what I'm talking about. But their hands are, you know, trying to pull you down, you know, because they don't want what's best for you. They don't want what's good for you. They want you gone. You know, they had this is This is what they want from you. They want to pull you down into the graveyard for you to stay there. They want to bury you because they feel as though you are a threat And that's what they do. If you don't deal with yourself, and that's why I put this out so much. I throw this out there because it matters. It matters. This is the way you survive. I have the guideline. I'm trying to tell you what to do. This is what you have to do. You have to deal with yourselves. People are suffering from this energy. They're suffering from all the past, all that baggage that they've been dealt with, they've been carrying for so long. But this is the guide. This is what I'm telling. This is what you have to do to get up out of your hole. You don't pull nobody down in your hole with you. You get out of that hole. You don't pull nobody in there with you. You get out of it. Misery loves company. That saying goes best with this. That demon or that person that's dealing with all that demonic energy, and eventually that demonic energy turns, that demonic energy needs a vessel. It needs to be attained. That's all it is. It's a demonic spirit trying to get into your temple, trying to get into your empty vessel, and eventually you become that demon. That's all that demonic energy. It's all demonic energy finding containment. You are the containment of that demonic energy. Therefore, you're looked at as a demon, So now this demon needs company. Misery needs company, It's demonic energy. What's demonic energy? Demonic energy is just negativity. You're full of negativity. But instead of taking tips or taking advice, they rather just sit in their misery and try to pull any light or any person that's feeling good down into their hole. They want to pull you down. They want to bring you down there with them. No matter whatever, they don't care about you. They care about themselves. So that's just what it is. You could tell someone as much as you want to, but no one will take advice. They won't receive help if they don't want it. They have to want it for themselves. If they don't want it for themselves, then it's only so much you can do about it. You've done what you need to do. You can't focus on anybody else. You can't focus on them. But all you can do is help yourself, because helping yourself can be all you can really do for the next person. Helping yourself could be helping that person. It's other ways. It's more than one way to skin a cat.